Like this, the helmet isn't necessarily always protection. Sometimes a weapon. You know, so you get somebody that's, say, a linebacker that's 240 pounds, 235, 240 pounds, and run a 4.5 running into you. If you know, and he needs his helmet.
Yesterday, this thing went viral. Aaron Hernandez documentary, and you were watching it. Did you see it? Did you watch it?
We were watching it on TV. We was just kind of laying back, checking out.
Did you know him?
No. Yeah. We met a few times. We played against each other, obviously. But I didn't know any of that other stuff.
Very tragic story. Sad.
Man, yeah, man.
There's a lot of twists and turns in that story that I didn't know about. I was like, whoa, that's crazy.
Yeah.
He was from Connecticut, right? Like New Haven, one of those?
Yeah.
He was talking mostly about the CTE. And you know, you've been around people that, I guess they said the CTE, but the difference in their personality or whatever, I don't know. What do you think about that?
I don't know, man. A part of me is saying that a person just is the way they are. You know, maybe the CTE can't control them as much. Brings it out. You know, if you play any collision sport, you're going to have some kind of head trauma. I don't care what you do. Like, once your brain gets rattled, but that's not an excuse to always go off on the deep end either. So, I think that, you know, just if he did have, I think he said one of the worst team stasis, that he couldn't really prevent himself or control him from doing all the stuff that he'd been wanting to do.
Yeah, but he was popular. What a champion, right?
Yeah, which is even crazier because normally when you get in the spotlight like that, you refrain from doing the type of stuff he was doing, and it like didn't affect him.
It's probably when people go out,
first
up, first drinks, first and then they feel more like, I'm gonna, I'll do whatever I want to do. That's probably what that does. Cuts up the connection
of your senses of
right and wrong. Right and wrong. Yeah. Okay.
But yeah, we've seen boxers that I think have it, and I could see their personality. They act very childish, or like things that, like you said, may be in them, but it's not their. There's a guy who passed away a couple years ago. He was from LA. He fought Freddie Roach, but he was acting like a 10-year-old kid whenever you saw him.
Yeah.
Oh, I did some boxing.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I can't think of his name right now. He's Mexican.
Yeah, Mexican. But really, he was like.
Mondo Ramos.
No, not Mondo Ramos, but same era. But you know what I mean? Like, he was acting like a kid, like a 10-year-old.
Yeah, he could. Because maybe he had a happy-go-lucky time to anyway.
Yeah, it's true.
Fun and stuff like that. And it just took it more to that point. Muhammad Ali was kind of like it too. He was acting like that.
Yeah.
You know, doing like magic tricks and stuff like that.
And you're right.
Yeah. And he went out doing that.
Which should have happened.
Sad.
Yeah.
But that's the price when fighters pay that nobody sees them. When there are no fans, no money, no attention. They're just left with the damages. So they should set up some fund or something for fighters.
I think it's really good to get back to those fighters that went through the type of reward they went through and gave so much enjoyment and pleasure to all the people around.
You're right. Inspiration.
Inspiration. And they gave their hearts. I guess it's kind of like the military thing too. You go off to war and you come back and then there's no jobs.
Yeah, you're right. They don't appreciate you.
They don't appreciate you.